Dr. Anil Singhvi from India, from Indore, who is a medical doctor. And like about 1 to 2% of the doctors do different things besides the practice of medicine. And that's what he went to do years ago, 15 years ago. He started a spiritual and psychology center in
Indore.
And he has been practicing that ever since, has traveled, has been at Jaina before to talk about it, has been in YJP and Young Jain Association of Southern California asked us to connect and bring him here. The Southeast here. We are looking forward to his presentation, and he will be touching veganism part of our dietary habits as well. And not sure, Dr. Singhvi, whether you are aware or not, but out of 69 Jain centers in North America, we are the first one to declare a vegan Jain center. So every meal that's served here as a host, not private functions, but as a host when Jain center is, we always serve vegan food. With that, thank you very much.
Jai Jire.
Oh, Hindi tha ki Gujarati tha?
Hindi.
Hindi or English, Pradeep?
Na Jai Jina na ni baat kar raha.
Oh, okay. Universal. That's a universal language.
So, kya prefer karenge, Hindi ki English?
English
would be because the, we have a lot of audience who like this. It may be released on YouTube, so that way.
That's fine. So,
if you don't use mic, you'll have to speak up a little bit, please.
Okay. I can use the mic.
It's up to you.
Can you hear me?
You have to switch it on. You have to switch it on.
Now, you see what this is. This is an apple. And suppose I go and take a bite of the apple. I eat this apple. The apple disappears inside me. At some point, during the next few hours to a couple of days, this apple will be part of me. Sure? Whatever you eat is what makes you. What you are right now is made up of the stuff, what you eat, because that is your basic raw material. Right? We don't know at what point of time exactly the apple turns into Dr. Singhvi, but it will turn. Therefore, if I don't eat the apple, but if I eat something else, that will also become me. Or something else, that will also become me. So the human body, as such, has this very innate characteristic of turning food, turning material into living material, into material which is unique, material which is not found anywhere else in any other species. So the intelligence is there inside you. And then it knows exactly what to turn into. But if you try to give it the wrong raw material, you think it has the power to turn it, remove all the negativity and turn it into whatever it wants? No. If that was true, then you could eat and drink anything you want. You could eat potassium cyanide, nothing should happen. But it happens. Therefore, the choice of what you want to become is in your hands. Because what you're going to eat is what you're going to become. So, with that kind of introduction, we will go and focus on the brain. Why brain? Two reasons. First thing, I had developed this talk for young people. I had given this talk in India for a lot of young, bright students who were just going into college. And it pained me so much that if they are not able to use that beautiful piece of machinery inside your head to the optimum, it is a waste. We all know that we only use 5% of our brains. Can we increase that? Or can we use it more efficiently? The brain is the most active part of your human body because it uses 25% of the energy and oxygen that you consume from outside. So there is something which very, very important goes ahead. And in fact, Thomas Edison ne to yahan tak kaha that he said that the human body is nothing but its function is to carry the brain around. So he gave it that much of importance. Though I don't agree with that, but that is what he said, and probably what Edison is because of his brain, not because of anything else. So, aaj hum log jo baatein karenge, what we are going to talk today is going to challenge each and every one of your beliefs. I am warning you. Because it's going to challenge each and every one of your beliefs, like it challenged my beliefs when I learned this stuff. There is an innate resistance inside us. Hame sab maloom hai ki we know everything. And that is natural. But for the purpose of this next 1 hour, I would request you all to lay down all that you know aside. And look at the information, because the information is presented with stark facts, stark proofs, which it was presented to me and I could not ignore it. So what happened? So I had a lot of medical problems, but and I had studied a lot about diet. Bahut sari kitabe padhi thi. Like you guys have also done it. But there is two differences. One is reading something about it, knowing something about it, and doing something about it. So jab karne ki baat aati thi to hum atak jate the ki kya kare. Aaj hum jitni bhi tests ki baat karenge, jitni books ki baat karenge, wo sab maine bahut pehle padhi hai. But I did nothing with it. Because samajh mein nahi aata tha ki how do you do it? And then I came across this guy by the name of Eric, and he is in Canada, and he runs this Wild Fit program. And in this Wild Fit program, he takes you through the diet changes step by step by step for 3 months. And it's a challenge. They call it the Wild Fit challenge. And after you finish the challenge, if you are not satisfied with the results, he gives you your money back. I said, fine, chalo, no problem, let's take it up. So I paid him the money, and we had a group of 1200 students all over the world who started the program on the same day and went through small, small changes every week for the next 12 weeks. And this was coordinated with a lot of support from Facebook groups, video conferences and stuff. So, this is the picture of Vishen Lakhiani. Vishen Lakhiani was the promoter of this program. You must have heard about him. He is a spiritual kind of company he runs in the US, and he takes a lot of people and exposes them. He did this program, and he has a change in his physique in 9 weeks with no exercise, just change in the diet. So that was, I thought it was impressive, and that prompted me to also do it. So with that program, what we learned was nature knows what is best for you. Nature knows what is best for you. Nobody else knows what is best. The government doesn't know. The FDA doesn't know. You don't know. Nature knows. So nature has given us fruits, vegetables, nuts for 250,000 years or more of human civilization, as we remember, as we have record. Then agriculture developed only 10,000 years ago, when the production of food grains started, wheat, rice and so on. And then carbohydrates and sugars came only 60 years ago. So this is how the evolution took place. And if you look at these bushmen, these are African bushmen who still live in the bush. They have got no access to civilization. They do not go to gyms. They do not go to supermarkets. They do not have any access to scientific medicine. Look at their physique. Look at their build. There is no obesity. there is zero diabetes, there is zero heart disease, there is almost zero cancer. It's all been studied, these figures. Why? Because they do what nature has provided them to do. They eat what nature has provided them to eat. And nature knows best. So let's come back. Let's come back to the fact that we are now aiming for brain improvement first, and then the other half, other parts of the body. Now, the first thing is, brain is made, maximum amount of fat is there in the brain. 60% of brain is made of fat, right? And brain does need healthy fats for constant growth. And these healthy fats are omega-3 fats and cholesterol. Study after study now is demonstrating that jinka cholesterol kam hota hai, whose cholesterol is less, have poor brain performance. If cholesterol goes below 150, it's good, not good. So don't try to push it below 150. If you take statins like I did for 7 years to bring down cholesterol, you are going to wind up with a lot of other medical problems. So cholesterol is good. Omega-3 fats, kahan se milenge? From flax oil, raw nuts, especially walnuts is very rich in omega-3. Then you can take monounsaturated fats from avocados and olive oil. Now these two sources are pretty good sources of monounsaturated fats. Saturated fats you can take from coconut oil and ghee. So all of these are healthy fats, which you need to consume in good quantities. In the earlier days, even in the Bushmen days, 70% of their diet was fat. 15% carbohydrate, 15% protein. And aaj jo FDM se kehti hai, you should have 60% carbohydrates and 20% fat and 20% protein is useless. It is causing a lot of disease. So we have to increase the amount of fat we take, but we have to see that all those fats are good quality fats. So what fats we have to avoid? We have to avoid fats like oxidized cholesterol, which is from sunflower oil, soybean oil, groundnut oil, all of these, canola oil, they have fats which are omega-6 and which cause a lot of inflammation, which cause a lot of atherosclerosis, which cause a lot of heart disease and dementia. So these fats should never be taken, but we have to take all these good fats for optimum brain function to take place. Right? So you want to discuss about the fats first? Chalo, batao. Any questions?
Corn oil comes into the
same. Yeah, corn oil is like poison.
Poison?
When you say cholesterol, is it HDL you are talking about or LDL?
Very good question.
We are eating corn, then why corn?
No, we'll come to corn later on. First we are talking about fat. So listen, two things. Definitely corn and corn oil, corn ke baare mein baat baat karte, but corn oil, no, nothing to do.
The question is, like avocado oil, again it is recommended by, at least by Italians, that do not heat our oil. Eat the oil,
yes,
cold.
Yes.
Because what happens when you, Indians put the chong, yeah, so what does the quality of the oil is going to change once you put in,
yes,
the bagar mein.
Yes, yes. That is another very practical question.
Once you heat up.
Yes, you should not cook.
That's why cold.
You should not cook with it. For cooking, you should use coconut oil. The coconut oil does not change with heat. Kuch bhi nahi hota. When you add oil on top of salads and on top of dressings and don't heat too much, then you use olive, avocado, and so on.
Other than coconut, what other oil for cooking?
Olive.
Olive again,
well, there are various kinds of olive oil. Some olive oils are heat stable, which are like for cooking, and then there are the extra virgin ones which are for adding on salads. But in our house we use coconut.
What
so
about grapeseed oil works well with the heating too?
I have not any data on grapeseed, whether it is alright or not. Should be alright.
Right.
Yeah, should be alright. Should be alright. Now, in the question, brother, is very important.
What was the question?
The HDL and
I'm repeating the question. When you do a test now, everybody tells you about HDL, LDL cholesterol, triglycerides, and so on.
VLDL.
Right, VLDL and all. VLDL. The thing to understand is none of them are bad. Number one. Only when they are like in out of proportion, they become bad for you. But the most important is cholesterol. Total cholesterol should be enough to give you the building blocks for brain tissue, for all the hormones which are made from cholesterol, like your testosterone, your estrogen, everything is made from cholesterol. Cholesterol is the building block. Vitamin A, is all cholesterol se banta hai. Vitamin K, cholesterol se banta hai. So we need good cholesterol. HDL cholesterol should not be low, because if low HDL cholesterol means bad for you. So HDL cholesterol to apna upar rehna chahiye, wo hoega upar. By the time you finish this lecture, you will see that how it will come up. So all this is a little bit more hyped up than this thing. And therefore statins should never be taken. Because by the time we finish, you will see that you don't need statins. You will take care of your health problems without the need of any medication. Just by changing the way we eat. Now coming to sugar. Sugar is interesting because sugar was introduced into the diet about 60-70 years back. Uske pehle sugar tha hi nahi, hota hi nahi tha. And when sugar came, the sugar industry flooded sugar into everything. Sugar came into everything. Now at a current estimate, a person in America consumes 70 kilograms of sugar in a year. At an average. Some people take more, some people take less. So that is how much sugar we eat. What happens with sugar? Problem kya hoti hai? Problem hoti hai ki when you eat sugar, sugar causes a sudden rise in blood glucose. See, this is a normal rise in blood glucose which you have with a normal meal. And therefore, the insulin is also secreted and it also comes down with this glucose. So it is a smooth rise, smooth insulin release and smooth coming down. But when you take sugar, which is an unnatural food, sugar is not supposed to be used by nature in any case. But if you use sugar, what happens? A very sharp rise in insulin, a very sharp rise in blood sugar. And blood glucose, as soon as it rises, produces a very big increase in insulin. Pancreas works very hard. In kisi tarah se humko isko niche lana hai. So there is a spike in insulin. Because of this spike, there is a dramatic fall in sugar, blood glucose. Because all the glucose is then converted into fat. Once you put in the insulin, insulin will convert all the sugar into fat or put them into fat cells, and therefore it will bring down the blood glucose very fast. Once it comes down fast, it actually over exceeds. And therefore, it comes below normal. Because there is a lot of insulin, again falls. So there is that dip. Oh, dip hota hai, so you remember, when you take a meal, which is high in carbohydrates, and after a couple of hours, you feel very drained. You need to have a snack. If you haven't had a lunch at 12, around 2 or 3 o'clock, you think you don't have any energy. Why? Because of this spike in insulin, it will bring in all the sugar. Sugar level goes down, brain says, I want glucose, get me something to eat. And then you go and take another snack. So that is one. Another problem here is that this high level of glucose is creating lot of problems. What glucose does is, it goes and binds to your proteins, which we call as advanced glycation end products, AGE. And AGE jab bante hain, to wo protein kisi kaam ke nahi rehte. Like your hormones, like other enzymes. It goes and binds and makes them ineffective. And therefore, when it binds to the proteins in the brain also doesn't work at all. Brain ke neurotransmitters ki bara bachati hai. It cannot signal the things. And therefore, you get brain fog. How frequently I have seen my own kids, when they used to study during the exams, they used to go into their room for a study and they used to take a bottle of Coke or some aerated drink and some either pizza or something to keep them awake in the night.
What is brain fog?
I'll come to that. So what is brain fog? So later on, when they morning, they said, oh, actually I fell asleep after some time and then I got up and then I again studied. The study was not good at all. This was what was happening. that once they started consuming this sugary drinks, it goes up, brings it down, brain stops working. Brain stops working. So this is again a summary of what happens, that the brain needs a constant supply of glucose at all times. It does not need a supply of spike and fall, spike and fall, spike and fall. If it happens, your brain will not be clear. And brain will not be clear means brain fog will happen. What will happen, we'll just see. And therefore, the sugar causes a spike in insulin. Insulin converts the sugar to fat. And after some time, what happens is that when there is a lot of insulin being produced, now understand this very clearly. This is extremely important. What happens is when there is a lot of sugar eaten, lot of insulin starts to produce. First thing which happens is the pancreas starts to fail. That the amount of insulin that the pancreas can produce starts to fail. I think there is a story about Steve Jobs, who used to eat apples. He was very fond of apples. That's why he made his company apples. Yeah, and he used to eat apples. Or he just started eating only apples. He was subah, dopahar, shaam ko apple hi khaunga. I will not eat anything else. One day he just fainted, and he had to be carried out on a stretcher to the emergency room. And they found that his pancreas had failed because this constant supply of sugar from the apple, the pancreas started producing. One time, pancreas fails. So once the pancreas fails, the insulin level starts to come down. But on the other hand, when the insulin level is continuously high, the target cells, where insulin ko kaam karna chahiye, they also feel, insulin is always high, so they develop resistance to insulin. And once the resistance to insulin happens, blood sugar stays up, insulin stays up, and person develops diabetes. This is how diabetes develops. So if you want to measure, now this is an important thing you can do right away on Monday, that if you want to measure whether you are going to go into insulin resistance or develop diabetes down the line, go to the laboratory and measure your fasting insulin level. Fasting insulin level. It should be normal or below normal. If it is above normal, even though your sugar is normal, but the insulin pancreas is working overtime.
Do we have that particular test?
Yes.
For
that? Yes. It's available. All laboratories do.
You heard about blood sugar, post-pancreas?
Yes. That is what the general knowledge is. That you just do a sugar, fasting, postprandial, but that will not show you what is happening behind the scenes.
Yeah, but what is the particular test?
Fasting, insulin
level.
Insulin level.
Isn't that the A1C?
Nobody does it. But that is what you have to do. Go and do it. Or get it ordered and the insurance will cover you.
Is that the C-peptide test?
What is
C-peptide is different.
Okay.
Yes. C-peptide is different. But this is the most sensitive test, which I am also going to do on myself very soon, as soon as I get back home. That fasting insulin test is the important test because it will show you how healthy your pancreas is. Ki kal ko humko diabetes to nahi hone wali hai. Hum carbohydrate kitna kha rahe hain. That is one. The second test you can do is HbA1c. HbA1c. HbA1c, aap logo malum hai. It measures your glucose over a period of weeks to days. Right.
One question.
Yes.
How long the fasting has to be done or
should
be done?
Overnight.
8 hours, 12 hours,
no,
nothing like that?
No. 8 hours is good enough, 6 hours is good enough.
Why doctors don't do that insulin test?
Because they don't know.
Doctors don't know?
The doctors don't know. I am a doctor, I tell you, a doctor don't know. unfortunately, this is a long discussion, but the amount of nutrition being taught to doctors is zero. Amount of basic things which are taught doctors. We are taught how to tackle diabetes. Diabetes ho jaye to usko kaise karo? Arey, how to prevent diabetes? Koi nahi bata raha. Koi nahi bata raha.
So how are those two tests different? The fasting glucose test versus A1C.
Oh yeah. So A1C will tell. You should also do your A1C. A1C will tell you your glucose level over a period of last few weeks. Fasting definitely has to be normal. If fasting is high, then everything else is going to go haywire. But fasting is the end. When your artery is going to get blocked, so then you get the pain. That is the fasting. Like diabetes is already there. But if you are pre-diabetic or if you are taking a lot of carbohydrates, which is not good for you, it will show up in the high fasting insulin. It will also show up in the high A1C.
And, are you going to talk about how to reverse a brittle diabetes? All this damage is already done?
No, you do this, everything will be reversed.
Everything will be reversed?
Just bear with
me. Okay.
Absolutely. So, then what happens is, when there is high and low levels of glucose, then brain fog starts. And then because of the high level, advanced glycation end products, they produce. Or who products are more dangerous? They are highly inflammatory. They go and aggregate in the brain and they cause Alzheimer's disease. The problem with Alzheimer's is, Alzheimer's disease is the end disease of all this process. And once the disease starts, there is no treatment. So that is the problem. And Alzheimer's is becoming a very major health problem everywhere. Reason for Alzheimer's is what the carbohydrates we are eating now. So, high blood sugar then also is known to reduce brain development in children. And agar aapke kisi bachche ko, kisi ko ADHD hai, hyperkinetic bachcha hai, samajh mein nahi aa raha ki kya karna hai, that is because of diet imbalances. And once you correct the diet imbalances, the kid will become normal. So this is again, just to say, if sugar tastes good, you eat the sugar, immediately raises blood sugar, then blood sugar is high, body releases insulin, insulin lowers the glucose, glucose levels drop and you get hungry again, so you eat more food, the whole thing starts again and again. And this is the brain fog we are talking about. So brain fog, what will happen? They will be zoning out, there will be difficulty engaging in cognition, not recognize things, not understanding things, difficulty in learning, memory is slow, forget names, dates and events, hearing someone speak but not understanding what he is speaking, and difficulty staying on tasks. And this is really harmful for children, but then harmful for everybody else also. So this is the problem with brain fog. So this is what brain fog happens. You are there, but your brain is not there. Then coming to fructose, another very, very big problem. Fructose is there in all sugary drinks. It is there in a lot of fruits. It is present in high quantities in all fruit juices. Now, fructose cannot be converted into sugar directly. Fructose cannot be converted into glucose. Brain cannot use fructose. Fructose is always converted into fat in the liver. And therefore, this is converted to fat, and that fat is stored. कि हाँ बाद में जब जरूरत पड़ेगी तो उसको फैट को मेटाबोलाइज करेंगे. We'll come to that thing again. So fruits अगर लें, but excess number of fruits, excess fruit will always be high in fructose. So that is harmful. So let me tell you a good story now, and you will understand what I'm talking about. In the old days, when man used to live in the jungle, man used to eat whatever was available, whatever was seasonal. And fruits used to appear in summer, so man used to eat those fruits. And then all that fruit was converted into fat, the sugar in the fruit, the fructose in the fruit was converted into fat and stored as fat in the body. And when winter used to come, there was no food available. He didn't have supermarkets. He had nothing. So the food was very scarce. And therefore he had nothing to eat. That time, body started to use that fat stored in the body for the energy. So that fat was mobilized, it was burned, and person was fine. And then the next spring and summer came, and again he started to store that energy, and again that fat was released. Okay? Now, what is the problem now? There is no winter. There is always summer. There is always spring. You go to the supermarket, you get anything you want. Anywhere in the world, it's grown, it's there. Yeah. And you just pick it off the shelf, stock it in your refrigerator, and you eat. And once you eat, body doesn't know what is happening. Body is going to convert into fat and keep for the winter. So he keeps the fat. But you still go on eating. More fat. So the fat cells in your body today are the same fat cells which were stored 10 years back. Never used. Body is just storing. And those fats are those storehouses for toxins. All toxins are fat soluble, mostly. So if you have a toxin in the body, it goes and stores in a fat, this thing, fat cell. अगर वो फैट सेल को ब्रेक डाउन नहीं किया उसको मेटाबोलाइज नहीं किया इज गोइंग टू बी देयर टिल द टाइम इट इज डन सो एज ऑफ नाउ यू हैव द टॉक्सिन व्हिच वाज देयर इन 10 इयर्स बैक 9 इयर्स बैक 8 इयर्स बैक एवरीथिंग स्टोर्ड द फैट इज स्टोर्ड एंड एवरीथिंग स्टोर्ड देयर सो दैट इज द हैवॉक वी आर क्रिएटिंग विद आवर फिजियोलॉजी सो वी हैव टू नाउ गो बैक एंड नाउ वी हैव टू गो बैक एंड वी हैव टू ईट फ्रूट्स ओनली इफ दे आर इन सीजन Number two, you have to eat fruits only when they are fresh from the farm and not transported from Turkey. Right? And so, you will be forced to eat fruit only when they are in season, and in winter there will be no fruit because there is nothing in season. Yeah? 15 minutes?
Because we have another program. We'll go a little, but. Yeah, keep that in mind. Yeah, but we have.
So then we'll keep the questions for the last then.
Yeah, I also have a question. I came for veganism.
Yes, veganism, we are coming to that. Okay. It's coming to that veganism also. So sugar is everywhere. So if you have to take off sugar, you have to look at each and every food that you eat. Suppose you have a racehorse. Racehorses are very expensive. They are a piece of reality. And you pay a lot of money for that racehorse. So are you going to feed the coke to the racehorse? No. So why don't you treat yourself like a best racehorse? Give you the best things that you want. So this is one book which I recommend you should read by William Davis, cardiologist, Weak Belly. I read this book about 4 or 5 years back, but now I can understand what he was saying. And finally we will go a bit faster and we will take veganism and we will take about wheat because these are two very, very important things we have to understand. And then this is the second book, which is Green Brain by David Perlmutter. He is a neurologist who has then done a lot of research work on this subject. So I'll tell you about this history about wheat. Wheat was discovered about 10,000 years back, not more. Our history is 250,000 years. Out of this 250,000, last 10,000 years we have discovered wheat and started cultivating as a grain. And at that time, wheat had 14 chromosomes and corn wheat. But over a period of time, it started to mate with other grasses and the chromosomes went to 28 chromosomes. And finally, now it is 42 chromosomes by genetic modification. There was a famine in 1960s, if you all remember, a worldwide famine. And then this scientist by the name of Norman Borlaug started to work on wheat. This is Mexico. And he made new ways to increase the crop yield, how to increase the pesticide resistant, pest resistant, and so on. And therefore, the yield increased 15 times more per acre with his genetic experiments. And he was given the Nobel Prize for this effort. And this is the Life magazine cover showing this guy. But what happened in between was that the wheat never remained the same wheat. Wheat completely changed. So now the wheat is something which looks like wheat, but it is no longer wheat. What is inside the wheat? Wheat may be opiate. You know opiate? Opium. Yeah? Opium. Yeah, it is something like opium. So there, the structure is like opium, and this goes into the brain and works like opium, stimulates your appetite. Then what it also does, that it goes into the intestine and punches holes in the intestine wall. And leaky gut. This is known as the leaky gut, where all the bad substances which are not supposed to get into your bloodstream starts to go into the bloodstream. Once they start to go into the bloodstream, there is an inflammation. There is an inflammation and an autoimmune reaction. And this autoimmune reaction can then lead to arthritis, it can lead to atherosclerosis, heart disease. It can lead to inflammation in the pancreas, causing diabetes. It can cause bronchial asthma and a lot of other things. The other thing you have to understand is the glycemic index. What is glycemic index? Glycemic index means that sugar kitni badhti hai kuch khane ke baad mein, kitna fast badhti hai. So if you see the glycemic index of sucrose, which is sugar, is 59. The glycemic index of white bread is 69.
The glycemic index of whole wheat bread is 72. Therefore, if you take two slices of bread, it is equivalent to take 5 cubes of sugar. And going to shoot up your sugar so fast. And therefore, all that wheat, it gets converted to fat and gets stored in the middle. Therefore, as we have seen, the production of the wheat increasing, the change in this quantity of the wheat, quality of the wheat, the genetic modification of the wheat over the period of years, we will see the obesity rise in UN United States going up. From 1960, it is to 40% levels are now obese. And similarly, diabetes. You can see how the incidence of diabetes is also increased from 1958 to 2009. So that was the wheat, but the wheat say apne ko bhi ye samajh mein aa raha hai, there are substances in the things which are harmful, and so we come down to the other thing which we have to understand is lectins. What are lectins? So this is another book you have to read. So the three books I am recommending, The Plant Paradox, this is written by a cardiothoracic surgeon, a very well-known cardiothoracic surgeon who used to do bypass surgeries till he found that you can cure the disease without doing a surgery. Without being bypass surgery, you can open up the arteries just by changing the food. So a lot of stuff is now available on the internet and YouTube. Lectins kya hote hain? Lectins are substances which plants produce to defend themselves. Wo plants aisi cheeze produce karte hain ki animals usko khayenge to animal bimar pad jayega. And therefore the animal stops eating it. Animal stops eating it, but we are fools. We go on eating them because we don't know what's good for us. I'll tell you a case in point. Defense mechanism kya hota hai ki jo husk and bran hota hai, jaise wheat ka chilka hai, the cover of the wheat contains all the lectins in it, all the wheat germ agglutinin in it, which causes punches the holes, causes leaky gut and all the other problems. It is there in the cover. So if you eat, if you grind the wheat with the cover intact, whole wheat, whole grain is going to put all the lectin into your food and it will make you sick. So you are not supposed to eat whole grain food at all. Then lectins can also act as phytates or anti-nutrients, which then impede absorption of other nutrients. Then they can also impede the digestion by enzymes, and they cause leaky gut and other disruption, and so on. So bahut saari cheeze hain, iske detail mein nahi jaate, but they also cause brain fog, interrupt communication between cells and neurons. कहीं पर भी कम्युनिकेशन हो रहा है बीच में आके बैठ जाएंगे, कम्युनिकेशन नहीं होगा, द ऑर्गेनिज्म इज गोइंग टू गेट सिक. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, रिसिन इज अ लेक्टिन. रिसिन इज अ लेक्टिन व्हिच वाज फाइंड इन द कैस्टर सीड एंड इट इज लाइक 6000 टाइम्स मोर पॉइजनस देन साइनाइड. 6000 टाइम्स मोर पॉइजनस देन साइनाइड कैन बी फेटल व्हेन इनहेल्ड, इंजेस्टेड, इंजेक्टेड. And it was used to kill a Bulgarian dissident, Georgi Markov, in London in 1978, when one milligram of ricin was put on his body and he died immediately. So this is the thing which plants can do to protect themselves. This is another dangerous form of lectin. So this is wheat germ agglutinin, jo wheat mein hota hai. And what it does is, it causes the intestine to decay. Now this is a rat intestine which was given wheat. And over a period of time, you can see that it became totally, this is the intestinal villi. This villi mein se sara function hota hai, sara food ka absorption hota hai. And once you give them this, all these villi starts to decay. And finally, the intestine becomes smooth and bald and is of no use completely. And further, it is punched holes, that is separate. So villi bhi pure pure khatam ho jate hain. So wheat germ agglutinin gets inside the body, attaches to fat cells and makes them immune to insulin. Uska function insulin jaisa rehta hai. To ab insulin aake isko kehta hai ki dekho, we have enough glucose, so you don't this thing, take glucose. Nahi, insulin doesn't work. So fat cell go on accumulating fat from glucose. Attaches to muscle cell. Muscle cell ko attach karenge to muscle cannot glucate glucose. So muscles waste, you become weak. Even you are eating more and more and more wheat, but you are becoming weaker and weaker and weaker. And finally, it binds to nerve cells, so no glucose enters the brain. So you are feeling all the time fatigue and all the time brain fog, just because you are eating that thing. So if you take out wheat from your diet, you will have all these benefits. You will have weight loss, which is dramatic, substantial, reduced appetite, blood sugar reduction, joint pain, inflammation, blood pressure, triglyceride, increased HDL. ये सारी चीजें जितनी अपने को चाहिए सब हो जाएगी. So this we have to understand that these are lectins which we have to avoid or we have to take care of. So क्या क्या है lectins में? These are the common lectin containing foods. So we are not eating brinjals, we are not eating groundnuts, we are not eating potatoes, we are not eating green chilies. Green chilies में ज़्यादा होता है. Then all beans. But the good news is that if you do them properly with pressure cooker, then the lectins get destroyed. So if you have to cook beans, you should always put them into pressure cooker and pressure cook those beans. And don't just bake them or do anything else like that. So these are the common nightshade vegetables जो avoid करना है. All these nightshade vegetables are again not naturally produced in the country. So we have to avoid all these. And sorrel has got lectins in it. All these have that's not spinach.
I know what is sorrel. I eat it. I'm just saying.
Speak with
him. Go back and check out lectin content. Anyway,
what are those bottom three?
One is I think cucumber. One is a pumpkin. That is a pumpkin, and that is you have to.
I'll come back and show the original photo.
Anil bhai. Anil bhai.
Yes.
Just one bhai.
5 minutes.
Okay. So veganism would be if you can.
So now we come to dairy. So in dairy, we have a human evolution of 5 to 6 million years. Dairy has been there only since the last 7,000 years. So what were people doing when there was no dairy for last so many millions and millions of years? They were healthy. They didn't want to drink milk. 99.8% of history we managed well without milk. Now milk is species effective. Cow's milk is loaded with fat, protein, calcium and growth hormones. Why is cow's milk produced? Cow's milk is produced for the calf, for the kid of the calf, cow. And it is intended to make the kid very fat, very big in a very short period of time. Therefore it has got a lot of hormones in it, lot of protein in it and lot of calcium, which is much more than what we require. So wo cheez, that is one. And secondly, no species in on earth drinks the milk of any other species except us, right? Then the milk also has antibiotics and growth hormones which are injected to the cow to produce more milk, right? And then the mastitis is there in the milk producing organ of the cow, gets inflamed, so there is infection there. For that infection we give them antibiotics. And then what happens, there is white cells or pus cells are present in the milk. You can see them in microscope very easily, and you can also ask the FDA for their content. They will be there. So whiteness of the milk is supposed to be due to the white blood cells or pus cells in the milk. So that's why what we are drinking.
So what about organic milk where they say there's nothing is injected to cow?
That is good. If they can do that, if they can do a very human kind of dairy, which I think is very not very common, if you can still find that, it's good for you. But let me finish. And then what is SCC? SCC is the pus cell count. So pus cell count should be less than 750,000 per ml. So legally a 250 ml glass of milk will have 180 million white blood cells, and FDA will say it is safe to drink. FDA ka ye yahan pe cut off hai 750,000. So in New York they did a study, the average count was 363,000 per ml and bacteria were 24,400 per ml in pasteurized milk. And it was certified safe for human consumption. So this is what happens when we are drinking the milk. So if you want to drink milk, you won't drink, but you will be getting pus, 135 million pus cells, bovine growth hormones, antibiotics, sometimes less with feces as well, 51 milligrams of cholesterol, pretty high, 300 calories, again very high, 16 grams of fat, and acidic protein. The milk protein is acidic, which leaches calcium from the body. There has been a study that in the highest number of milk consuming countries, three countries, where India is also one of them, the bone health is the weakest. Why? Understand this. So what happens is, when you drink milk, the protein is acidic, goes into the intestine, produces a lot of acid, that acid got to be neutralized. For the acid to be neutralized, the calcium is used from the bones to make a buffer. And that buffer then goes and neutralizes that acid and it is excreted with the in the intestine. Therefore, the more milk you drink, the more calcium you lose from the bones, and the bones become weaker and weaker and weaker. Milk consumption has also been linked to so many very bad diseases like ovarian cancer, lymphoma, diabetes and so on. Calcium. So, now this is one thing that the FDA and the milk producing companies will say, drink milk for the calcium, drink milk for the calcium. So, where was we getting calcium before we started to drink milk? Before 6,000 years, 5,000 years. Where was the calcium coming from? Number one. Number two, how much calcium do you really need? And number three, is milk a good source of calcium? So, let us answer these questions. Human milk calcium levels are very low. If you analyze the calcium in breast milk, which is given to a baby, the calcium level is much, much low. Cow's milk has 431% of the calcium which is there in human milk. So we are consuming heavy amount of calcium in the this thing, which is much higher than recommended. So excess calcium is associated with increased incidence in hip fracture. Take more calcium than required, your bones will become weaker. International rates of hip fractures are high where milk and calcium consumption is high, that I already told you. Neither milk nor high calcium diet reduces risk of hip fracture, and that adequate vitamin D is associated with a lower risk of hip fracture. Vitamin D is more important than calcium. Right? Now, finally, there was a study done on Bantu women, again African tribal women. They don't drink milk. They don't drink milk. And therefore, what happens? They give an average of 9 children. Breastfeed each child for 2 years. Kitne calcium ki zarurat hai unko, hai na? Then they don't have calcium deficiency, they don't break bones, and they consume only about 350 milligram per day from plant sources. But US FDA bolta nahi 1000 mg khana chahiye. Japan ka FDA bolta hai 600 mg khana chahiye. Kya figures kya hai? It's just arbitrary figures. Eating too much animal protein including milk can cause you to lose too much calcium. That should be understood. Then final problem with the milk. In 2000 years ago, there was a mutation in cows. And cows kind of mutation hua, so the cows started to produce casein A1 in the milk instead of casein A2. This is the type of protein in the milk. And once this was produced, the casein A1 is now converted to beta-casmomorphin. It attaches to beta cells in pancreas and mounts an autoimmune response to the pancreas and causes diabetes. If you have to drink milk, don't drink casein A1 milk. Try to get casein A2 milk, which sometimes you can get in the market now. So finally,
You didn't say what are the other sources of calcium then?
Oh yes. So other source of calcium is plants, all your spinach, all celery, very high level of calcium. And I will just give you a solution to that and in the next slide. How do you take care of all your nutrition?
Water is a source of calcium also. What is it? The hardness in water,
yeah.
Calcium and magnesium is found.
So we are running out of time, so we'll just go rush ahead. And so I think I was given 1.5 hours, just about 1 hour.
We have another program that would start at 1 o'clock, 12 to 1 was lunchtime. I think there was some probably misunderstanding, 1.5 hours.
Exhibition.
So I'm sorry about it, but Dr. Singhvi will be here during the lunchtime and in the afternoon until by 6 o'clock. There is a lot of time for a interaction, one-on-one basis. And also, we would like to see, I think this is a great slide presentation that you have. Me being a physician, we understand all these things very, very well. And what you tell this story, I can say it is my story as well. I have lost 35 pounds of the weight in the last couple of years.
That's fantastic.
Don't you want to?
Which people would need to go for the exhibition and paintings may leave, but otherwise the rest can continue for another 10-15 minutes.
And some clarification on that. Excuse me. So registration is 12:30.
Oh, I see.
With some leeway.
So we have 15.
And lunch is till 1 o'clock. Okay. 1 o'clock is the workshop
time. We've got another 10 minutes, Dr. Singh.
Yeah, because if I don't answer the questions, it's going to be useless.
No. You just answer the questions.
Because I was given 19 minutes.
More important than 60.
Dr. Singh, you can just get to say.
Carry on.
We'll consider this as a preview of a long talk in the future, probably.
So I'll just tell you my story, what happened. So my body weight was 70 kg, this is about 8 years back. I had mild high blood pressure. I had acid reflux for 25 years, for which I had to take a drug every day. And then I had very poor sleep, and sometimes I had to take sedatives. I had high blood triglycerides and low HDL. Nothing used to bring it up. Then finally, I had triple vessel cardiac angioplasty 9 years ago. Then I used to have brain fog, felt de-energized in the middle of the day, and couldn't concentrate, and so on, so many problems. So then I started this MindFit thing, and in 3 months, what happened? I lost 6 kg weight in about 15 days during a period in the program. Then blood pressure became normal, acid reflux disappeared completely, it's never come back past 3 years now. Sleep has become perfectly normal. Blood triglyceride normal, cholesterol normal, HDL has gone up, no drugs. Then angioplasty is doing fine, and no problem there, body checked, and brain fog is completely gone, and I feel energetic, and I feel good. So when I saw that I had this benefit, I started to share this with other people, just to see how people can understand. So if you have a Mercedes, or if you have a bigger car than a Mercedes, and you are proud of it, you are not going to put in water in the gas tank. You are not going to put in kerosene in the gas tank. You are going to put in high-grade fuel, don't you? So why don't we do the same with our bodies? Treat that as a high-grade Mercedes. So that's about it. And then I have a few slides on caffeine if you are interested. I can just tell you in 5 minutes about caffeine, and these facts will also blow your mind.
Sure. Yes, please.
Now, caffeine, you know what? How it was invented? Caffeine was invented as a natural pesticide.
Indeed. Pesticide.
Yes. When the caffeine plant produces caffeine, it kills all the plants around it so that it can grow well. If an insect tries to touch it, the insect dies. And this is the pesticide chart where you know this is Roundup. You know the Roundup? Yes. Roundup is the pesticide which is used. Glyphosate, which is used in farming, and it is extremely bad. That's why we go for organic farming. Okay? So Roundup ka jo toxicity level hai, wo ye haan par hai. And caffeine is right here. See here. So caffeine is actually a pesticide.
Yes.
But then what happened? Then clever people thought that let's feed it to humans. So they diluted it and made it into coffee. And then they started to market it as coffee. When you take the coffee, body recognizes that this is poisonous. Body tries to excrete it, and in response to the poison, the body produces adrenaline and noradrenaline, all the hormones. So, us adrenaline or noradrenaline se humko high milta hai, a kick milta hai. And you think, oh, yeah, we're doing fantastic. But then again, it goes down, and you need another cup of coffee. And that is how it works. So, they did brain scans of normal people. You can see this on YouTube, of a person who drinks some coffee. This is MRI before that and MRI after that. It produces 40% less blood flow in the brain. 4 cups of coffee a day can be deadly. This was a study done on 43,000 people. Their life expectancy, if they drank 4 cups of coffee or more, they dropped by 50%. This was published in a very good medical journal. I think. Yeah, 4 cups.
What about 1 cup of coffee in the morning?
Then maybe you will do much better than not. So, coffee is an artificial stimulant. Therefore, coffee or caffeine is present in colas, it's present in tea, it's present in coffee. It should be stopped. It's very difficult to stop. I used to drink 6 cups of tea every day until I went into that program, and overnight that guy told me, stop. It becomes so difficult. I mean, you can't function. But after 4th, 5th, 7th day, you start to become acclimatized to it, and then you give it up completely, and that which I have done completely now. So it's not difficult to do. So finally, the important thing to consider, to finally sum up, you need good nutrition. There are 2 things to do. Keep away the bad stuff, take the good stuff. But the more important is, take the good stuff. The more good stuff you take, the bad stuff is not going to be that much problem.
Does cooking those lectin-high vegetables help at all?
Yeah, we took out all the lectin vegetables also.
But you can cook them to help?
Yeah, if you do the pressure cook.
Pressure cook.
Right? So what we do is, in the morning we make a smoothie. In the morning we make a smoothie of all the good things. Spinach, celery,
broccoli.
And then cilantro, mint, basil, avocado, lemon, little bit of spices, and then in the beginning you can use the apple to sweeten it a bit. Later on, after 2 weeks, we just don't put the apple because we don't need any sugar, right? So then you blend it in a Vitamix, completely blend it, and drink 3 glasses of the stuff over the day. Not necessary to drink immediately. But the first thing you should do is take this rather than your morning cup of coffee. That's what we have been doing. That's what everybody in my family now does. And we are so happy with it. Take out nothing. Just blend it and take every good stuff which is right there. So you will get all your calcium, all your iron, and all your multivitamins, and all the plant enzymes, which are so important for you. In this. So this is the green smoothie we do.
What is the brown thing is that?
Oh, that is just some spices. As per your taste. And this is how you do it. This is my blender. This is my blender. I took it from the US. I took a big transformer because it was 120 volts. It's sitting here behind it. But we do it every morning. And it just works quite fantastically.
So you filter it?
No.
No filter?
No. Why don't you want to take out any of the good stuff?
No. I mean to say the juice.
No, kuch nahi hota. It just becomes completely liquid. You use a high powered blender, Blendtec or Vitamix.
Okay.
And it will just completely liquefy it. You can put ice, you can put whatever you want to do to make it more. And this is how you make this good stuff. So, I think this was all for the younger kids. We will not go into this now for shortage of time, about how else you can improve your brain function. And if you have time of 10 minutes, we can do a meditation.
Huh? I want to take a picture of
that. Oh, okay. Which one?
Vegetables.
If you do nothing, do this. That is a good start. That's a very good start.
That is not a problem. We are not extracting oils. Right.
Okay. What about reversing the diabetes?
Yes. Now, if you do this, okay, I'll give you a very simple answer to it. I had a friend who is also a doctor, who is also a little bit obese, 28 years old, bad diabetes. Sugar not getting controlled. It did insulin, this, that, everything, nothing was working. One day he met me, kya chal raha hai, ye problem hai. I said, tomorrow you give up wheat. That's all. Only one prescription. Give up wheat
what?
And me.
Give up what?
Wheat.
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 So, khayega kya bolenge? What do you eat? I said, you can eat millet, you can eat jowar, you can eat bajra. You can eat jowar, you can eat bajra, you can eat rice. No, no, diabetes and rice?
Brown,
what?
Brown rice.
No brown rice. No brown rice. more lectin in brown rice.
Nobody knows.
So, eat the white rice and you will see, and that is also documented, how people who eat the white bread, like Italians, and the white rice in India, they have much less problems than all the other people who eat the this thing. But I'm coming back to the story. This guy, I told him that just do this. And he did it. He and his wife took out all the wheat next day. In 1 month, his diabetes was normal. He lost 5 kg weight. No dieting. As much eat you as possible. 5 kg weight, his skin cleared. People used to ask him, what are you doing? You look so good. मैं कुछ नहीं मैं जाता हूँ पार्टी में चावल लेता हूँ दाल लेता हूँ ढेर सारी सब्जी लेता हूँ खा लेता हूँ दैट्स इट बट यू हैव टू डू इट आई हैव गिवन यू वीट फॉर 3 इयर्स नाउ आई जस्ट नो प्रॉब्लम्स
व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट आल्सो द लेंटिल बट इफ थिंग्स गेट स्प्राउटेड डज इट मेक अ डिफरेंस
नो 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 दैट इज इवन वर्स दैट
इज नॉट
No, the lentils which are bad, these are the lentils which are bad. Moong you can do, but avoid sprouts. A lentil you can eat all. Lectin is not good. Lectin is not
good.
So beans are not good because beans are high in lectins. But if
Anil bhai, why not we complete your presentation
okay. and then discuss.
Then ask the individual question because what happened, if one guy asks one question, the rest of the people has to wait for the rest of the information.
Absolutely.
So why don't you finish the whole presentation and we'll ask the question.
Absolutely. So I will also tell you about this stuff because this applies to us also. If you want to improve your brain power, I'll ask you a question. Are you going, suppose you have to work on a project. An important project, business project or a project in the office, are you going to prepare for the project by working on a crossword puzzle or going for a brisk walk?
Brisk walk.
Right? You guys are so good. Brisk walk is the right answer. Because it has been shown that exercise improves brain function. Exercise, aerobic exercise improves brain function. Therefore, if you want to study first, you have to go out and play. Exercise reduces the protein, it decreases brain development, increases the organ, it is a good protein, increases blood flow and so on. But aerobic exercise is important. Right? Then emotional health you have to do, we will not go into details because of shortage of time, but how to improve your emotions, how to take care of emotions, how to become, get rid of negative emotions and so on. And focus. And focus learning, best thing is meditation with visualization. And I can take another hour on meditation if you want because I have been into it a lot. But this is what you have to do. So, if you are alright with it, we can do a 10 minute meditation right now to take care of everything.
I think you can skip the meditation today.
Okay.
There's a lot of pressure, time pressure.
Okay, no problem. So, the time to today to change is today. Just don't lose the present moment. That's what I'm saying. And this is my contact details if you have any questions, anything at all, any help. I will be always very, very willing to help you out.
Thank you very much.
I have Instagram, but it's in the car probably.
We have time, people who are not for the painting, please feel free to talk to him, ask questions. He's not in a rush. We need to get him to the airport for 4 o'clock. And in the same token, if there is anybody who can volunteer, I'm looking for one to take him. But otherwise, he's going to fly to catch for India at 7:30. He was very generous to detour himself to come out here to give us this talk. So we appreciate Nirbhay your time here.
Thank you.
And I know there have been some misunderstandings, etc. But you got the audience.
Yeah.
And I have one thing about crowd who is relatively less.
This is all right.
No. Yeah. I want to say something. this is the challenge that we as Jains are facing in probably all over, but definitely North America. When you talk about making money or practicing rituals, we all run. When you talk about something related to your own health, we do not. So, please, round of applause for all of you here who are interested. And it is never late to change anything that you believe, learning from this or other things. I'll tell you my own story. In the last 2 years, I have lost about 15 pounds. I've gained 3-4 back on that. There was no reason. Thank God I have no medical problems except osteoporosis, and we won't go into that. I take calcium and other things, but nothing like diabetes or high blood pressure or heart attack or shit. No, nothing. And still, I felt that I needed to lose belly fat. And I have reached some success with that, not as much as I would have liked. But the point I'm trying to make, I certainly feel myself, with the loss of only 10 pounds of my body weight, I'm more energetic, I sleep better, and I didn't have any of these problems before also. But, you know, it's an afternoon brain fog that probably we all get, especially after lunch, and that's kind of gone away from me. Whatever that means, good or bad, and I'm certainly, not only me, but even my wife, we are certainly more particular about what we eat and what we don't eat. And it's not that I don't eat any specific things, I eat everything. But my quantity of sugar, quantity of fried things have gone really low. We don't deprive ourselves simply because we don't have any disease to fight with right now within the body. But the point is, it's never late. And every little bit of a thing that you will do will help you. And just think this other way. Whatever is your age, obviously, you're not going to talk, but if something that you love you did for 50 years, 60 years, 30 years, well, time to change and not do the same thing. So at least you have next 50 years better than where you are. And you already enjoyed that for X number of years anyway. So with that, thank you very much, Anil Bhai.
Thank you.
Yes, some of the things I would admit as a doctor I did not know. So, not all, but some of the things. So, he is right, because the whole medical field is an evolving field. We always keep learning newer things. And some of the things go away. Best example I always like to give is about smoking. It was so cool when it started, right? And I'm sure some of us already tried that. And now, of course, we know that that's probably the worst invention ever made. Same thing will happen after time about the opioids. But opioids is a different story. It's still required after surgery, but not like smoking. So thank you. Thank you, Anil Bhai.
So yes. Any questions?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's about oats.
Yes.
People can get oats. So why don't we just let people know what they can eat for breakfast?
Yes.
Because there is oats available.
Yeah, oats, and the problem is that
jene javu hai jai sake che je log na besu hai, we can ask the questions.
Please ask questions. No rush.
Yeah.
It's okay, people are leaving. Anyway.
Yeah.
I don't know what is the thing. Yeah. Go ahead.
And anybody who asks question, if you could ask in a louder voice, so everybody would
Answer
the question. And so that might relate to the
question.
Super craving.
Yes, yes. Very important question. Very important question. So, we got two important questions. Two important questions. One is about oats. That's a definite problem. The thing is, to get gluten-free oats, if you can get gluten-free oats, then you can take. Because all the oats generally which is made are made in the facility which handles wheat also. I also take gluten-free oats. I do that.
Yeah.
I do that. So you can do that. But you have to get the gluten-free variety.
And it's good for people who want to eat a breakfast, which there's plenty gluten-free oats available from Whole Foods or Sprouts.
Yes.
And you can eat with nuts, and you're going to have a
nuts
fantastic.
Nuts are amazing.
And it's a fantastic breakfast.
Yes.
Maybe we should serve at Jan
Center. Normal oats is not the gluten-free, right?
No, normal oats is
It needs to be labeled gluten-free.
Free, okay.
Yes. The other thing is the sugar monster. And so sugar monster bolte hai, jo ki craving karta hai. It's sitting on your shoulder. Just a little bit.
When it's like especially when I'm hungry.
Yes, that's the monster which is asking you ki you should add sugar, you should have sugar. I mean, there was no time because I was describing five types of hunger. Why do you eat? So, in one of those is this craving, emotional craving which you get. So when you get that, you have to take care of it in the sense ki, you know, tell it, okay, I'll take care of it. Just postpone by 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, it goes away. Then another urge will come, ki thoda sa le lo, again postpone. And once you start to do that, your taste buds will change. It happened with me, ki over a period of a month, after you give up sugar, your taste buds will change. And the moment you put a single bit of sugar there, it will taste so sweet, really, ye kya hai? You don't like it anymore. So it is all a matter of, you know, training yourself.
So natural sugar, like a date or...
Dates is fine. Yes, yes. But no processed sugar, zero. No brown sugar, no white sugar.
Good either.
Good, I would say, initially you can do, like, but the less you take is...
Now, you were also mentioning about some goat milk and then
yes.
the goat milk
yes.
yogurt and there is a sheep milk yogurt.
Yeah, that is because of casein A1 and A2.
We have A2 milk available too here.
A2 milk hai toh le sakte hai.
So, A2 milk yogurt is okay?
Yeah, that is okay from the point of view of A2.
Yeah.
Yeah. Casein is fine.
Yeah.
But then the other things like the pus and the other things and din, is always with them. So,
not overdoing it, but just take some.
So, agar jaruri hai lena, if it is important, you take the A2. If it is not important.
Yeah, but if somebody doesn't want to take any supplement for a postmenopausal or let's say above 60 man or woman.
No supplements, I have never talked about supplements
at
all.
Yeah, but you need to drink it. How much spinach you have to eat to get a calcium supplement?
No, you just do the smoothie. And drink 3 glasses.
That's a lot.
Okay, drink 2 glasses.
Initially.
No, 3 glasses.
Initially,
no,
it's a lot.
He's telling 3 glasses
in the whole
day.
You have to train your brain.
You have to get the whole bag of spinach
per
or
day?
Bunch of spinach.
Per day, 2 glasses?
Yeah, no,
three glasses
per day, yes. Per day. So you don't have to eat. You will lose weight.
You don't have to eat anything else.
You don't have to eat anything. You will lose weight.
My doctor, my cardiac doctor, I was there yesterday.
Yeah.
He said that you cannot change the pattern because, you know, I have high...
Change what?
Like a high triglyceride, high, you know, everything.
Yeah.
My bypass was done, you know, my...
Okay.
You know, so he said that you cannot change the parents, you know, you are genetically...
That is all bunkum. That's all useless talk.
So, genetically...
Kuch nahi hota hai. Kuch nahi hota hai. I give you a guarantee.
If you follow these
methods, which are detailed in all these three books, ye teen kitabe aap padh le, mere pe mat jaye. All three books have got lot of data, studies, everything after. You are eating natural food. You are not eating statins, you are not eating drugs, you are not going for bypass surgeries, nothing. Just do this.
Okay.
And you will see that there will be dramatic change. People will not recognize you.
No.
I tell you.
You were saying about the midday brain fog. I think most of the people, I think it is for... If you eat a food more than you require, that two things happen. You have high insulin surge,
yes,
because of the,
yes,
load you put it in, and high insulin surge can put, you can create a brain coma medically,
yes,
by giving insulin. So, and all your blood rushes to digest your food.
Yes, yes.
And that is why when you come out of Jai Bharat, you are half dead.
You don't go to that.
So it means no fruits at all, right? Then
it's the quantity.
Fruit
and
you have to take in very moderate quantity, small quantity.
Too much oil anyway.
And also
no,
only,
I'm just
only
saying,
when in season.
Eat the food.
Season much healthy.
And also, what is the thing with the monosodium glutamate?
Oh,
I think a lot of people avoid. No, if Americans stop eating monosodium glutamate, please do not look at any aisles in the grocery store. Every food you have, if you just don't give up anything except just say, I will not eat that as monosodium glutamate. The minute you
put it, that's a preservative.
Minute you decide that, you will give up 100% of the food that are sold in American aisles. 100%.
That is the unfortunate truth. I
decided that once with my life long time back, and I think it is
all
very
the packaged
easy.
Foods.
Huh?
All processed foods.
All processed food. You should. You, that means you will be out of it.
I gave up so many food, but you know, still like.
It's because of the things which you are taking, which are causing you harm. The wheat, the dairy.
No, wheat I don't take.
You don't take wheat at all?
No.
Amazing.
At least it's better, but you have to exercise.
She's still young.
Sir, what is EFT?
Okay, EFT is a method by which this is known as emotional freedom by tapping. Basically, you tap on certain points. It takes about 5 minutes,
uh-huh,
and it just blows out your negative emotions completely.
Oh, yes.
Suppose you are feeling very down, you know, something bad happened, somebody told you something. So you are feeling down. Oh, hota kya hai ki we go on you in that mood for hours and days together.
Correct.
But if you learn this method and you just do this. And in like 5 to 10 minutes, that emotion you cannot find inside yourself.
Really?
So, do we get that one in you from your website?
No, I don't have a website. My website is about cancer because I'm a cancer doctor. So you won't get it there. But I can send you, if you send me an email, I'll send you resources where you can, you have noted down my email. And then somebody wanted the good books.
And I think only other thing difference about the ghee is you need to make the ghee out of cultured butter. Yes, cultured butter is available in the store. It is just more expensive, but it is available.
This is first book.
Yes.
I have an e-book on this. If you can email.
I know the good drink, but not but the rest of it.
Yeah. If you email, I can send you this book by email. That's not a problem.
The
other two books.
It's online.
What is the first book, you said?
Yeah,
first book.
Online.
Yeah, yes. The first book.
No, that's not the first
book.
That's what second
book.
That's
the third book.
This is
another
book.
This is the second book. This was one more, right?
Yes.
This is the one about the wheat.
What was the very first book you said?
Yeah.
Wheat belly or something like that.
Yeah.
Wheat belly.
I also have this on ebook, so if you want to email me, I'll send you the book.
I don't have
it. PDF copy, right?
Yeah.
I know, but I can download
it. I have a question.
Yes.
Change the first one,
please.
All the three are best-selling books, and all the three are written by scientific doctors.
Consumption of tomatoes. Now, tomato is a fruit. First of all, it's not. Tomato and brinjal come to the same family.
Yes.
They are not vegetables, they are fruit.
Yeah, she's right.
Okay. So, tomatoes is consumed by people, but Italians eat the tomatoes without the seeds.
Without the seeds and
without the skin. That's how I eat it.
Really?
So, yes. For ages.
What kind of skin?
Of course, tomatoes, you never eat the skin. If you want to taste a good knife, try to cut a tomato. If the knife doesn't
tomato?
Cut the...
Oh.
That's rough, and it separates out even if you cook. But best is to just you put in hot water and then put in the cold water, tomato skin will come out.
Yes.
That's one way. And then you cut the tomato into half and squeeze it. The seeds will come out. You only need the meat of the tomato, and I think nothing will happen to you.
In the kathor, we say that, you know, like a lentil. So, you know, the usme, which one it's you say that suggest to eat? Like a mung dal, aapne bataya.
Yeah.
You know? So, what else?
See, all dals are all right. All dals are all right. Like mung dal,
chana dal,
but we have to pressure cook all of them.
Pressure cooker.
How about slow cooking on like longer period?
Whatever, I mean, pressure cooker is important. You can do it along slow thing or whatever.
So slow cooking is nothing but the longer time, but yeah, it is still the pressure.
But supposed to be a lot of questions are coming up for people cooking under pressure food and how the nutrition is destroyed.
That's wrong.
Well, I don't know. Everybody says something is wrong when you don't believe. And people in India don't have a slow cooking process.
Yeah. Once so we are protected.
Three glasses of those things for day.
Like, I know it's not the key point is once a week fasting, which is we are not doing it.
Which one you call a fast?
That's fine. You have to fast
all day long.
All day long.
Doctor, the question I had was, like, I've been vegan, not 100%, but mostly vegan for a couple of years now, and I have severe osteoporosis, very severe. So I don't take medicine for that. The doctor is pushing me, and I don't take it. Now, friends I know, the relatives I know, they drink milk, and they don't have any osteoporosis. So,
sorry, don't compare yourself with anybody else. What you have to do is take care of yourself. Yourself, you should take care with all the natural sources of calcium.
Right.
Get enough sunlight.
Yeah, I do that.
Get some sunlight. Go for a walk every day.
Yeah, I do
sunlight.
That. Exercise. I do
and
everything.
You report back in 3 months and you'll see. You can go on. 100%.
So how come people who drink milk doesn't have osteoporosis?
They have.
They don't know.
You find every patient with osteoporosis, they'll be drinking a lot of milk.
Yeah.
In India, everybody drinks milk.
People, some people I know, I mean, not all. I mean,
some people don't get
it. Yeah.
But
I'm going to stay vegan and
you should.
And I don't take medicine for that.
Yeah.
All right, thank you.
Look at the number of people. Aaj tumhe kal ke pata mishran banavani prakriya to aaj 4 gana marth bata rahe.
I know.
No, people should stop giving, not only, we should stop giving vegan dessert here. Why are we giving dessert?
I don't know. Somebody
only is not the vegan people is coming here. Lot of other people is coming here. So, whoever believes, they don't eat.
I look at this thing. People sometimes don't have control over what not to eat. I don't serve me any food and I won't eat. But
only 10-20% people don't want the food and the dessert. 80% people
don't want the food. But somebody is paying for the food. We don't pay. If you pay for your food, you have a choice what to select. You are not paying for the food, sorry, give up the rights.
You have a wonderful opinion and it's a right. So, but then there are, Trump ne kya elect karya? ગાંડા લોકો વધારે છે કે
નહીં
ગાંડા લોકો વધારે હોય તો આપણે કમ્પ્લેલ કરી
શકીએ
વોટ ડઝ ધેટ કેર વસ્ત આપણે જ્યાં સુધી આપણે સ્તરીય નહીં ત્યાં સુધી બીજાને
નાસ્તી ને ગુંડી એટલે કામ કરે
નો પર્સન પીપલ વોન્ટ્સ
વોટ હી ડઝ ઇઝ ધેટ હી ટેલ્સ યુ હાઉ ટુ ટેક યોર કેન્સર એન્ડ કેન્સર
યે ઓન ધ કન્ટ્રી તમને અગર કોર્સ કહીશ ને લોકો ને તમે તમારા ઘરે બર્થડે આટલો સારો સેલિબ્રેટ કરો છો તો ભગવાન નો બર્થડે અહીંયા સેલિબ્રેટ કરીએ તો અમે સારા મિષ્ટાન ના ખાઈએ